not a huge deal to me.
Got this, man. I thought you got a little frustrated. I was like, when you hit that ball and it went underneath the thing all over there, I was like, who's he mad? It's all good. You played a good game though. I mean, overall. They've been making mistakes all night too, so. What are you doing now? Hanging off?
No, I'm hanging out.
this. I'm starving. Football, baseball, basketball have all started, and I can't say that I missed it. I don't really watch sports to begin with, but... I've heard a lot of people say that. There's a few people that are like excited for like the college football, but like NFL, they're like,
yeah. I watch the Chiefs, that's my game.
The only time I ever really watched anything was if it was the Super Bowl. I'd watch that. That was it. up, buddy?
Hey, Jeff Boyard.
Gordon. My favorite thing here.
What are you doing?
Recording for her. Can't really complain. It's election year, so it's kind of weird. Nah, just people. Everybody gets worried about election time.
They're hoping.
They don't know whether they're
not going to go away no matter what. July 30th again.
Oh, congrats.
And 3 days later, I got called from the government and asked me to come back to work. That's like nothing.
The government?
Yeah, when I did the stuff and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
All that stuff. What's up, Matt? How did you think that four ball performed?
Four ball, pretty good.
I would use it. Unless you get some of those phone balls. I got a bunch of them. I'll give you some of
them. I don't think I've used
it before.
Huh? I've
never used it before. There's an indoor and outdoor ball. I'll get on this. Yeah, I just got my new skis the other day.
Looking forward to that?
Oh, yeah.
Some people have been complaining about, like, the Franklins and Duras. Sometimes you get a bad match. It wobbles.
Yeah.
It's frustrating, actually.
Yeah, we just did a test of an indoor 10 ball. And they tested it. They wanted it to be with people that I tested it with. We had to sign it to the and they're coming up with a new ball. It's a few different colors, red and like hot green and hot blue. And different material, and it's just, it stays better. Does that make any sense?
Yeah.
You know, it maintains the roundness, because they're,
it's almost like an indoor ball.
Yeah, well, it is an indoor ball. Yeah, they're pretty happy with the 10 outdoor balls. Less breakage than a lot of manufacturers, and they stay round.
We go through so many balls here, and they break, they get soft spots, and they wobble. It is kind of frustrating.
The process is weird. The guy sent me a video of the process. It's almost like they put them in a tumbler at the end, you know, to get the edges off and stuff, and then the burrs are out. It's really weird. Then they come out with that smooth surface. Then you gotta break that surface down.
That's interesting. You send me the video if you get a chance. Or if you
still have it, I will.
That would be cool. See how thick the ball is made.
It's pretty neat. The pen balls are made in Austria.
What?
The pen balls are made in Austria.
Austria?
Yeah. That's where Ken is based out of. Like I told Brian, I just got my seat for the year. Oh. Who is that?
Renee.
What's her name?
I don't remember.
Huh? No, I don't remember. Renee. You guys have the same apartment all the time. All the time.
This is the second apartment.
Huh?
This is the second apartment.
Tonight.
No. It's not like that.
Okay. Same
it's not like my whole.
Right.
Yeah, they all have the same part.
Yeah, that'd be nice. That's
why they have matching t-shirts.
Right. Yeah. I can't come over. I'm probably going to fail. Karen's got a demo.
got one. Michael's got one. Karen's got one. Todd, of course, has one. I think Jamie has one. They're nice. I mean, I think Chase has one. Ching's got two now. How's your wife doing?
Good, she's in Colorado climbing from 14,000 or 14,000 or whatever they call it. Sunday. Having fun. Going back to Telluride.
Nice. We haven't been anywhere. Well, I think about we went to Eureka Springs to stay in a treehouse.
Oh, cool.
I'm 1.2 million.
Gene Woodard?
I don't know who.
There's a friend of mine that produced a ski lift lot. His son and daughter own Woodard's Mercantile. He owns all the farmland around that. So first they developed such a similar $500,000. And so he pretty much, he moved up to Grand Lake. Yeah, Grand Lake out by Winter Park. Oh, he calls Debbie and I up one night. Come on, let's go to Denny's, guys. Debbie's like, all right. Sold my first piece of property for $1 million. Farmland. He said, in the 70s, they couldn't give it away. And they didn't want it. They were using it for beef cow and wheat. And then as time went on, they came out with it. And now it's good. I guess he's got like 20 acres of farms that he put on. All the other stuff up there was Woodard's.
Yeah, I don't know who it was. It wasn't even a full acre. It was like 3/4 acre.
Yeah.
It was 1.2 million. Is it even real estate? Yeah. But because there's already developers out there,
it's right behind that credit egg thing. There's a hospital right behind it. There's a little piece of property behind it.
Yeah,
yeah, that would be Gene's or one of those other farmers up there.
Yeah. Whoever it was chose the real estate after he said, sorry. Let's do the win. picture of us real quick? Yeah. Did he grab the camera? I'm a tell on this up front. It sits through the biggest.
Thank you.
I know he's Cody's son, I just couldn't remember his name. I wanted to call him Cody Jr.